I grew up in Miami and I was a Miami Heat fan, and LeBron James left the Heat in July of 2014, and I was just depressed. And I would go and I would look at all the highlights from LeBron and D-Wade, and I would get depressed. So I try to look back at more moments, and it really bummed me out that there were moments that me and my friends would always talk about, and they weren't on YouTube, they weren't on ESPN, they weren't anywhere. So I said to myself, there's gotta be a spot where all the things that me and my friends talk about in our living room, where we can find these videos. And I would do some research. I spent about a month trying to find spots that had these same moments that me and my friends talked about in our living room, and there was nothing. So a month passed, it was August of 2014, and I said, I'm gonna do it myself. I went on Instagram, I put an account name, it was The Highlight Factory. A week later, I hated it, so I changed it to the name House of Highlights, and ever since then, it's just been taking off. It's ridiculous. I've been working 1,200 days straight, and you go through all 400, 500 DMs a day, and you miss a day, and now there's all of a sudden 1,000 DMs you need to go through. So it's been a crazy process, and I can't believe that I've been here since day one, and now it's at 7 million, gets 400 million views a month. You never thought you would be the guy that would pull all this off by yourself. It was weird, because at first I didn't want to take credit for starting the Running Man Challenge, and those two guys that were in college, the basketball players, they sent the video to House of Highlights. They went viral. There was hundreds of celebrities doing the Running Man Challenge, thousands of people doing it. And they went on Ellen, and I couldn't believe that it started all off because of a video that they sent to House of Highlights and that I posted, and then after that, everyone picked up.